If you had one word to describe the trip, what would it be?
Definitely inspiring.
Breathless.
And fucking incredible, man. If that's even a word. Don't tell me where we're gonna go. Just take me. Yeah, you're the only one who knows how to save me. Don't tell me where we're gonna go. Just take me. Just take me.
So for this Transcenders trip, we actually flew into Phoenix, and then we drove up to Antelope Canyon. The next day, we went to Zion National Park. Third day, we drove over to Nevada, Valley of Fire, and then we went to Las Vegas after that.
But this time, we brought the girls.
Icon living, start a record label, Miss Fish just did it. Nylon cover 5 minutes. Whoa, we are too hot in the business.
So as soon as we landed, we had to rent the van this time, and then we had to haul ass over to Antelope Canyon to try to make a tour.
And we just took off. You know how our trips go, dude. It's like non-stop, you know, action, go, 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 go.
We got there with about 20 minutes to spare. And to get out to the actual Antelope Canyon, they hauled us onto like this big old army truck in the back.
And when we got to the location, it was pretty surreal.
At one point, like, you look out back and all you see is like that red dirt road. It really looks like another planet.
What up, guys? Hey, we're out here at Antelope Canyon right now. We're about to go inside the cave, as you can see behind me. Check this out. Hey, what do you think so far, man, of this tour?
It's great.
Our tour guide, she was awesome. She was just showing us all the little spots to take photos of.
Yeah, look right up there, please. Now pretend like you're taking a photo.
She's good. She's really good.
What our tour guide did, she had a flashlight. And so she would set up a lot, like she would like light things up for us so we could take pictures or like video and stuff. And she was like I said, they're knowledgeable, informative, and she's like, oh, this is how you take pictures? Like, they're super cool. So like, even if you don't know how to use a camera and stuff, like bring your phone, bring something.
So that was our jumping photo. As you can see, I got no hops. We just got done with Antelope Canyon. We just went through the whole tour. The place was amazing. Amazing photos, taking amazing video.
One of the definite bucket shots we wanted to get was the sun setting over Horseshoe Bend.
And I think sunset was like setting in like 30 minutes or so. So
as soon as we got back, we had to haul ass into the van trying to get over there to try to get the sunset. So we're already crunched for time.
Hold on, so right now, sunset. We're trying to catch sunset at Horseshoe Bend. And
The shuttles just stopped running, so now we gotta rush to the parking lot.
Sure enough, as soon as we get there, I mean, the parking lot was just full, so we had to make our own parking spot.
Yeah, that's thing. How you mother do it.
All right, guys, we made it. Ooh, dirty. All right, everyone, we made it here to Horseshoe Bend. We're about to catch a sunset.
He grabs his shit. He's like, I'll see you guys later. And he takes off. Me and Vic are behind with the girls.
As soon as I got up there, I didn't have the wide lanes down there.
We didn't miss this.
We got there, me and Vic found a spot, and then we're just like snapping away, dude. And just like, holy, like we were just walking out there and looking at this spot. It's massive, dude. It is huge compared to like pictures.
Horseshoe Bend was amazing. This is probably one of my favorite spots.
I was just amazed, dude, at how big this shit was. Like, I couldn't believe it.
Bad news, guys. We didn't catch the time lapse of the sunset, but we did catch golden hour, and it was amazing. Just like perfect lighting, dude. It was gorgeous.
That wasn't even it for day one.
We ain't the only crazy ones.
Later on that night, we went back to Horseshoe Bend
and tried some long exposure shots.
We're back out here to Horseshoe Bend.
We get out there, it's cold.
Cold as hell. Cold. It's pitch black. We had a little headlamp and everything. We navigated our way out there.
It's currently 11:21 p.m. at Horseshoe Bend, and we just started taking some long exposure shots. As you can see, the camera settings.
We didn't know what we were doing, but we still had a pretty good time out there.
The next morning, we went to Zion's National Park.
We heard from some of the locals they had a pretty bad snowstorm the night before, and a lot of the shows and the roads were shut down, and a lot of even the trails were shut down. But it turned out the trail that we wanted to do, which is up to Angel's Landing, they had just opened that up around noon, and that was around the same time that we got there.
Mother Nature.
We're here at Zion National Park.
If you've ever done Zion before, you know, that first part seems the longest, you know, because it's all uphill.
We're about to go ahead and embark on this adventure.
And it's supposed to be icy and stuff, but the traction should help us.
That's what tires people out the most.
We got the snow spikes.
You're so dumb.
We got the hiking poles. We got the gear, zip away cargo pants. We're ready to go.
The first part of the trail was okay, so we hiked without spikes. We
made it to Walter Wiggles. Let's check this out. It's a pretty deep, steep incline. See at the top.
About a third of the way, and that's when we put our spikes on because it's sort of like sloped more once you get like in between like the narrow paths.
There were parts in the trails where you literally had no traction and you just had to trust yourself and kind of like balance yourself.
water wiggles. Not too bad.
Yeah,
the right gear. Spikes and pole. Let's go.
It was time to start going up Daniel's Landing.
I decided to stay back.
Kevin unfortunately had to stay back, so sorry Kevin. But he already did it already, so it didn't matter.
Now, here comes the real test. Angel's Landing, baby. Let's get it! Boys and girls, and we are on our own. Listening to everything from grunge to rock and roll. Our feet don't touch the ground. Fly like a plastic bag that's left. We got lifted.
We wake up pretty early because we wanted to hit up Valley of Fire State Park before Vegas.
Drive out to Nevada was, it was pretty scenic. I mean, we drove through like three different seasons. As soon as we left Zion, it was snowing, and then it started getting sunny, and then it started raining, and then it snowed again, and then it started getting sunny, and it was just crazy.
So after Angel's Landing, we went to Valley of Fire.
What's up, guys? We are out here in Nevada now at the Valley of Fire. Feels good to be in the sun again. You and me, we could do big things on the run again. Chasing all our dreams for the fun of it. We're holding on to things we can't see, but we're loving it. Ooh, oh, your soul is glowing. Heat of the moment, I feel it growing.
Drove about 2 hours over here. Now we're done with the drone shots and getting ready to go inside the state park. See y'all there.
All right, guys, we're here. We're still here. We're about to go ahead and take the shot, the infamous shot that you've seen on Instagram. It's been everywhere, but we're right here at this location. Get out. Alright guys, we're right here outside and we're catching these antelopes.
Oh yeah, go tell them what it is.
Hey guys,
on this episode of National Geographic, we got these, I don't know what they are back here, but they're antelopes or goats. I'm not sure, but look at them in their natural habitat. Look at that, amazing.
So after that, we were on our way to Vegas.
Las Vegas. So once we got into Las Vegas, we checked in. The sun was setting again. We wanted to make it out to Seven Mountain or Seven Magic Mountain. I forgot what it was called. What is it called? Anyways. So again, we had a haul ass out there.
Seven Magic Mountains, we were kind of short on time. It was definitely getting dark outside.
Right now, we're at Seven Magic Mountains. Check this out. We got a little crazy weather that's going on. If you look over here, you got these little clouds that are coming down with rain, and look to the left. Got cotton. hot colors.
Say we are finally done with our trip, and I'd like to thank you guys for coming on this trip with us.
Once again, thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. I appreciate the love that you guys have given us, and don't forget, do more, baby.
I'm tired as hell. I'm heading back to Dallas, but these guys are gonna stay and try to win our money back.